This is the solution to written homework 78. Okay, so we can do A and B at the same time. So R of X is X minus 1 cubed. And then we can factor out a negative 2 out of that quadratic. So negative 2. And then factoring that out, we get x squared minus 3x minus 10. And then does that one factor easily? Yes, it does. So that would be x minus 1 cubed times negative 2 times, that'd be x minus 5 times x plus 2. Okay, and therefore the zeros can be read from that factorization. The zeros are x is 1, x is 5, and x is negative 2. Okay, C. Make a sign chart. Well, there's three fence posts. There's negative 2. There's positive 1. And positive 5. So that would be negative 3 could be a sample point. And how about 0? And 2 and 6. So what we're going to do is we're going to take those sample points and plug them into that factored expression. Okay, so then plugging in negative 3, that would be negative cubed, and then negative 2 is always negative. And then negative, and then negative. Bunch of negatives there. So now plugging in 0, that would be negative cubed, negative, negative, and then positive. So now we have negative cubed, negative, negative. Oh, wait a second. 0. So that should be plugging in 2. That's positive cubed, negative, and then negative, and then positive. And then plugging in 6, that'd be positive cubed, negative, positive, positive. Okay, so that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 negatives, so that's positive. And then that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives, so that's negative. 2 negatives, and then 1 negative. Okay, so there's the sign chart. So now we can plot these zeros. So negative 2. Now let's use a dark color. Negative 2. Positive 1. And positive 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got those three zeros, and notice that at every zero, there's a sign change. And therefore, that's a crossing. And that's true of all of them. Positive to negative, negative to positive, positive to negative. If the sign didn't change at a zero, then that would not be a crossing, that would be a bounce. Okay, so we start high, and we end low, and we cross at every zero. Okay. Well, something like this. Yeah, that would be good enough for an answer. So now, this is fine, but if you were to carefully plot, that graph, then that 0 at 1 would actually look a little bit different. It would end up looking like this. So this is a degree 1 crossing, but at 1 that's a degree 3 crossing, so it's going to end up looking like this. That's the answer.